My name is Tarun Mohr. I'm the founder of a co-working space called Kokarma. We're based out of Hyderabad. We have 4 centers here. And we are a completely bootstrapped company. Currently, we have about 560 seats at our different centers. And so as a service, what we provide is we provide dedicated desk and we provide private cabins and some options to companies. But our primary goal as a company is to help companies grow. So currently we are, you know, helping them with their space problems and solution around their space or office problems. But in future, we're looking to help them with their marketing, their HR, their recruitment, and other problems that they, a company or a startup might face. So that's what we are as a company. Our journey started way back in 2014. And the way it started was, it didn't start in India, right? I used to work and live in Australia. And I used to attend startup events over there as well. And in around January 2014, I was invited to this event, which was held at a co-working space called Inspire 9 in Australia. And this is in Melbourne. And me and my partner, we went there and we were like, look, this is a, you know, really cool business to be in. They are inviting all the entrepreneurs and startups around Melbourne. And this is a good place where everybody can come in and sort of network with each other and help each other and grow from there. So we thought this is something really interesting that we could do once we go back to India. And at that time, we were primarily focusing on our education startup. Right? So we used to run a startup called LearnMore, where we used to provide tutors to people through an app. So we thought we'll go back and we'll focus primarily on our education startup. But it so happened that once we came back, we said we'll start our education startup from a co-working space. And we'll start a co-working space because at that time, there were not many options in Hyderabad. And especially at the locations that we lived in. And that's how the story of Kokarma started. So we started, we say that a lot of things in our journey started with questions and answering those questions. So the first question that we had was, is this a good business to be in? And we were like, definitely yes. This looks like a business which can create a lot of impact in the ecosystem that it is in. And we said, we'll build that ecosystem in Hyderabad. And we came in 2014 and said, look, we'll start off this ecosystem with our company and the entrepreneurs that live around the area that we are starting in, and we'll slowly grow from there. Yeah, so that's the start of Kokarma. And within this time that I have, I want to list our journey in a couple of more questions that we answered during our journey. So as I said, in 2014, when we started, our primary focus was running an education startup, right? And we were running that startup for quite some time from 2014 until 2017. And there were a lot of hurdles that we were going through in terms of raising funds, in terms of the business model that we were running. And it so happened that one day I was sitting with a coworker within Kokarma, right? So this at this point, I'm running two businesses. I'm running Kokarma and I'm running an education startup. So I'm sitting with a coworker within Kokarma who became a good friend 6 months after working there. And he was like, Tarun, you're struggling so much with your education startup. I see your co-working space full all the time. Why don't you think of growing this business, or why don't you explore something more in this business? And that's when we said, look, we are a small 40-seater space now. Should we look into this? Why don't we grow Kokarma? Is the question that came up. And we said, look, we'll think about this. We'll try and expand this. And then it so happened that within a couple of weeks, 2 more people approached us and said, hey, why don't you look at growing Kokarma? And we said, look, we'll expand this from a 40-seater space to another 30, 40 seats and see how that goes. So we made that decision, we made that expansion, and those additional 30, 40 seats got filled up within 2 weeks' time. And we were like, there is definitely something there. That we started with a small space, it was running full, and we doubled that. And then that sort of got occupied within a short span of time. And then the next question that we were looking at was, is there something here? Is there a market here that is growing? And if you think about the golden period of co-working that has happened in our country, it has happened between 2018 to 2020. So a lot of times entrepreneurs, right, I feel in life, have to make decisions when they're in the tide. They have to make a decision and they grow the market. And after the tide has passed, they sort of look back and say, hey, that was a golden period and that was the time to focus on this business and that was the time to look at building that market. So the whole market sort of co-working started exploding from 2018 onwards till 2020. And we grew from a small 40-seater space to about 560 seats now. And we have 4 centers. We have a few good locations. If you look at our infrastructure, it is one of the best sort of that we provide in the city. Moving forward to 2020, another question that we were exploring was, there is this whole COVID that has hit everyone in this industry. Is this a time to look back? Is this a time to say, look, should we hold the growth that we were going through? or should we look at shutting down some of our centers, which is what a lot of co-working spaces did as well, and or should we look at doing something else? And the question sort of that we asked ourselves was, is this something that we believe in, and is this something that is going to grow in future? And the answer to that was yes. We thought commercial real estate in its traditional form is going to disrupt with a very fast pace after 2020. In the short term, all the co-working spaces, including us, will suffer. But in mid to long term, this will be beneficial for co-working, and our growth will temporarily stop. But you know, in the mid to long term, this whole thing will sort of explode our growth, which is what we are noticing from the past few months. So we are getting so many inquiries from landlords to partner with us, so many people who want to join hands with us and be a part of this growth journey, right? Our targets for the next couple of years, so let's say from 2021 to 2023, would be to take this from a 560-seater space to about 8 to 10,000 seater space. So in the next one and a half year, will be another 2,500 seats. And in the next 2.5 years, we're looking at around 8 to 10,000 seats. So that's our journey. I hope this helps. I hope there are some stories that a few other entrepreneurs can relate from. Happy to answer any questions that Jatin or anybody else has.
Awesome. When you thought that, you know, now you will scale this business up. It's a very capital intensive business. Raise external funding, or it was bootstrapped?
Yeah, no. So it has been completely bootstrapped right from day one. And we have made that decision up until now, and we'll continue with that for some more time. But yeah, setting up a co-working space is a very capital intensive sort of a business. I would say the way we have done it is we've been at the right place at the right time. So when we grew from that 40-seater space to an 80-seater space, we took a bank loan and then expanded that. And expanding to another 40 seats is not that hard, and it's not that capital intensive. But from that 80 seats to about 560 seats now, we got our next space, which was completely built by the owner. And the owner was not able to lease that space out to anybody for 2 years. And he was like, look, I'm happy to give this infrastructure to you if you can run your co-working space and just give me a rent there. So that's how we expanded to the next space. And the space after that, somebody came to us and said, hey, I have this new building that I'm coming up with right in the middle of high-tech city of Hyderabad. It's in front of the new cable bridge in the lake that is there in Hyderabad. Do you want to do a co-working space there? I'm happy to take a franchise if you want to do a co-working space there. So the center after that, we grew in a franchise model where everything is invested by the property owner and the landlord. And we're managing and a franchise partner for them. Right. So, and that's how we're looking to grow the other centers as well. So we're looking at a franchise/management model to grow to other buildings and other sort of cities that we're looking at.
Okay. And according to you, which was the most impactful decision you made in your journey that really helped you scale up really well?
Right. So I think the most important decision was not just to start. I think the starting decision was easier, but to leave what we were doing with our education startup and focus on Co-Karma, I think that was the key decision in our journey, because it's very hard for you to let go what you were doing for about 2-3 years and then focus on something new, and you don't know whether this is going to work in the next couple of years. Luckily, it did for us, but that's the call you have to make as an entrepreneur, that whether this new journey that you're taking, whether that will work or not. So I think that was the most important decision that we took in our journey.